गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन।
गुड इवनिंग मैम।
गुड इवनिंग। We'll start in 2 minutes. Just an information, a few of you all were writing for the template of case history. I couldn't upload it because there was a power cut in my area. There's some fluctuation with the power, so I will be uploading it before your practice session. Just give me some time, I'll upload all the required templates which you can use in a few days time, maybe over the weekend. Okay, so any query from your end? We have been into the into 6 sessions now. Today is the 7th one. So anything you would like to know or talk about, let's just talk for 5-10 minutes and then we'll do one activity which is to do with emotions for children and applicable all throughout ages. The ones who have been selected for this particular workshop, they will get an assignment in the end. Okay, so it's a short assignment, it's nothing much, but you need to complete and submit. We'll send you a link in the WhatsApp group as well as via mail. So they need to complete the assignment and then submit, and then we'll forward you your certificates.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, I have my name is there in selected participant, but I'm not been added in any WhatsApp group.
Can you just text me once, please, ma'am? I think I added you in one of the groups, the main group, in fact.
WhatsApp, ma'am? No, ma'am. My number is not there because yesterday also you were told.
Okay, you just. Just text me and do it.
Right now, here.
You can text me personally.
Sorry? Personally?
Text me personally, yes.
I don't have your number, ma'am.
I will send it across. End of okay. The class, I'll send it.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so let's get started with today's session.
Hello, ma'am. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, I'm also not in the WhatsApp group.
Okay, ma'am, those who are not there and those who have been declared winners, please text me personally. If you're not added, I will add you in the group. Okay?
Okay, ma'am, you please send your number.
Yes. So, moving on with today's session. Next class, next slide, please, Roshmija. Okay, so today we are going to discuss very briefly on the limitations of a child counselor, and if we have a few of us over here as school counselors as well as personally into practice with children, let's just be an interactive session rather than me telling you what would be the limitations, and then we'll do the 4-season activity. That's a kind of a metaphor therapy which we generally use with children. Okay, so moving ahead with the first agenda of today's meeting, if anyone can share their experiences or what all challenges you faced as a child counselor, if at all, if you want
May
to share.
I, ma'am?
Yes, please.
Yeah, okay. My name is Mitali. I'm working as a school psychologist in Bangalore rural area. So whenever I have to approach any parent, they are thinking like I'm going to tell some kind of clinical symptoms and like some serious illness or something like that. So they are not ready to talk. Even teachers are not taking it very in an honest way. They are also taking like I will do something else. So they don't want to refer the kids. Even the parents don't want to come with us. Only like administration's pressure is there, but no cooperation from teachers or like parents. That is the, like I think that is the hard limitation for us.
That's the first challenge. What I feel whenever you are into a new setup, it's not only a rural school, it is also for urban schools. Like those who are working in urban schools will also come to this conclusion that initially there was a lot of challenge, you know, when you first approach teachers about counseling, and then when you approach the parents, especially parents, teachers are still now accustomed with the system, but parents, they totally deny on certain issues. And as you're saying, there's a pressure from the administration, of course, since if the principal has called or some authority of the school has called them, they are bound to come, but very reluctant on doing so.
Okay, madam, leave. We will manage. I know how to manage my child.
Yes,
always
yes.
They have that like line, always pickup line is there. We can manage, ma'am. We know how to manage our child. And that is the biggest limitation for, I think, all are facing nowadays. It's really hard in online also. So I am facing that one.
Thank you for sharing. Any other feedback?
Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
मैम, मैं अंशना हूँ और मैम मैं एक स्पेशल एजुकेटर का वर्क कर रही हूँ. तो मैम मेरे पास सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम यही आती है कि वो लोग लेक ऑफ एक्सेप्टेंस है. अगर बच्चे में कोई दिक्कत भी है तो एक्सेप्ट नहीं करते. वो कहते नहीं मैडम अपने आप ही एडजस्ट कर लेंगे, आप क्या पढ़ा रहे हो इनको. उसको ना एक मतलब इनको डर लगा रहता है कि इन बच्चों को टैबू मिल जाएगा डिसेबिलिटी का या फिर ये मतलब कि हमारा मेन काम होता है बच्चे का वेलफेयर करना, लेकिन हमें वो मतलब सपोर्ट नहीं मिल पाता है पेरेंट्स का स्पेशली, तो हमें बहुत ज़्यादा दिक्कत आती है. और उससे ज़्यादा फील ये होता है कि मैम हम बच्चे की हेल्प करना चाहते हैं और हेल्प नहीं कर पा रहे हैं सिर्फ बिकॉज की पेरेंट्स एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर पा रहे हैं.
एब्सोल्युटली
सबसे ज़्यादा प्रॉब्लम ही हमें यही आ रही है.
एकदम. द सेकंड पॉइंट आल्सो, यू नो, दे डोंट अंडरस्टैंड हाउ यू आर हेल्पिंग द चाइल्ड, how you're going about the sessions. They will want everything in a very short period of time. If you have come across parents, especially parents of young children,
actually parents are not accepting what the child are facing, the child what he is facing. Parents are not accepting.
Ekdam. I recently met someone, you know, this is a personal experience, recently met someone, as I was talking yesterday also, that the parent was kind of very confident that nothing is wrong with the child, but I saw certain symptoms of derealization in the child, eighth grader. Okay, derealization symptoms, which is very common due to the pandemic, because children are unable to move around and they have a lot of pent up energy within them. Chances are that there was a deep rooted problem in the child from the very beginning. But then, you know, you cannot explore further. They are so close, then they say that my child is saying that I need to talk to someone. I think it will help him talk to someone else apart from us. But I'm sure it's nothing, not much of a problem. But when I speak to the child, it's clear symptoms of derealization as well as deep-rooted anxiety, which I feel needs exploration. But you can't do anything about it. If you are practicing alone, you're practicing independently, then you still have a chance to confront the parent and tell them what is what, you know, maybe as a opening session, maybe not alarm them, but at least give them certain information. But in a school setting, it becomes very challenging, extremely challenging, because you tell them something and they'll take it in a different way and put it across in a very different way. While we were doing this, we have several times come across this. There's a lot of miscommunication of what they understand and what actually you feel for the child. You know, how you can help the child. They take it as a kind of a taboo for the child. You know, my child is going to the counselor, that means kuch na kuch garbar hai. What will other people say? This is a state.
Yes, ma'am, right. Yes.
Even those who are independently practicing, even for them,
ma'am, I want to share something. Can I share something?
Yes, Jolly.
Yeah, I work with adolescents, PU students. So there, usually teachers refer for individual counseling. But last year, what happened? When the offline class started, so what I did, I started visiting the classes and giving some ideas about what is role of counseling and what all activities we do. All those things I spoke to them. Then after that, I started with some art therapy methods. Mm-hmm. I used that person standing in the rain drawing
right
with one class. So I told them, so this is just to understand about your personality. And I will help you to analyze and reflect on the focal points in the drawing. Mm-hmm. But after that, if you feel like you want to get some help from my side, I'm ready there. I'm ready to help you. That's what I put it.
Mm-hmm.
And I told them, and if I find that there are certain things, okay, I need to discuss and there is a concern, definitely I will call you. And they said, yeah, it's okay, they said. And I started, and I think nearly out of 50 students, 20-25 students I got for counseling.
Wow, wonderful.
Yeah, that's the way I started, because especially with adolescents, it's very difficult to get them talking for counseling. So this year also, it's everything is online. So teachers referral I get, but other than that, I started this classes again. So I spoke to my principal and I took permission from him. He's a priest, so father, I want to visit classes. Then he agreed. So last week I started again visiting classes with this drawing activity, but with the different classes. So now I told them it's not for any counseling activity. This is only to help you to understand your personality, because right now it's pandemic time, just to reflect on and just to get some insights about your personality. So that's why now it's going on like that. So wonderful. Some students will reach out to me for some help. Otherwise, it's like a group counseling.
Right.
Otherwise, you won't get any, especially.
Absolutely, anything. Absolutely. So I was coming to that, Dolly ma'am. Thank you. Othri, you had to say something before I proceed.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, yes. I was, what I wanted to say that the problem which we face with children is that since they can't come to us and, explain what they are feeling, it becomes very difficult to exactly understand what's going inside them.
Right. They are not very expressive with words. Maybe they have a lot of things inside. So, of course, expressing emotions or understanding emotions becomes very challenging. So, we'll do one short activity today with understanding emotions. And as Dolly ma'am was reflecting on a strategy of class counseling, I've been telling you from the very beginning, rather than focusing on individual children when you enter the school, you need to build rapport and you need to psychoeducate the school at length. It will take some time. Maybe the first year will go on doing one particular thing only. Going to classes, talking to them, being around and doing some activities like what was suggested by ma'am. It was a drawing activity. Then telling them that it's not a counseling session as such within quotes.
Yeah. So
it's more of an orientation about who you are, understanding yourself. Maybe you can have some catchy phrases for your workshops. So more of workshops will make children feel secure because others are also participating. In different schools, we have these life skill classes, QCTD, quality circle time. So these classes are for maintaining that rapport with you.
And last year, I did also with the self-esteem class. It's not one class, 10 classes.
Mm-hmm. Modules.
So it's a group counseling. So we have 10 or 15 enrollments. Mm-hmm. So we were doing it online only.
Right. And children also connect with you, when especially preteens, teens, they find it really nice once they are able to express and they see their friends also starting to talk. Initial sessions, they won't talk and not everyone will talk. You'll just have 5-6 children who are interacting.
But one challenge I faced was on online, they will not switch on the video.
Yeah.
It's a very
kind of innovative ways in order to make them switch on
the video. They won't switch on the video.
What I tell them, if they don't switch on the videos, I you know, kind of tell them to always interact via the chat. At least I know they're interacting, yeah. They're understanding.
Yeah, that's then
maybe, maybe there's a reading to be done or some kind of response to be done. So I call out names and ask them, what do you think about this particular thing? Okay, or can you lead the group into this? So at least I know that they're listening.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's very important. And of course, you have to keep on motivating. This is the biggest challenge for us right now, that I crack jokes. It's like a double screening right now. Once it's already pandemic and we are virtual, and then again, I don't see any of you. So it's like double the distance which we are having. So sometimes they do switch on, and then it's again their whims and fancies. I keep on trying, keep on motivating. They'll also give in maybe sometimes.
And we have to do always research. That's the biggest thing.
Yes, yes.
Research all the resources.
Yes. And being a counselor, you need to have a tool, you know, toolkit list. What all things do I know? It's not possible to know everything in the world, but whatever resources you are getting, keep it in one place, keep it in one folder, write it down that I have these things with me. I know about these strategies. I have these particular techniques to be used in these particular areas. So have
art therapy has created that.
If you have the entire list, it becomes much more easier when you are, you know, trying to implement certain things in the class or with the child. So it becomes way easier for you. It's like a glossary. It's like an index. You just refer to it and then you know what exactly to do. So that's like creating a toolkit for yourself. Okay, so let's move on with today's activity. As O3 had highlighted that children cannot express much, you know, verbally, they cannot express much. It's only through their actions or certain behavior we come to know about what's actually going on. But again, it becomes very difficult when there are deeper emotions inside or about their mood, how they are feeling. They remain confused most of the time. Okay, so this activity we will be exploring through art. So I'll give you maybe, and it can have different improvisations. I can tell you the variations, how you can do it. But for the time being, I want you to write down, like it will be like a chain, okay? So in the chat, since it's virtual, otherwise we would have had one paper and each one of us would have written it on that paper. But you can use the chat box and start writing. If you were a season, which season would your mood reflect? Like how do you feel about each of these seasons? And how are you feeling right now? Say I'm feeling like spring. So whenever you're telling the children, younger children especially, keep it to four basic seasons. They all know about summer, winter, monsoon, and spring. So it would be like 4 to 5 seasons and 4 to 5 emotions and how they're feeling right now. Okay, winter, summer. Fine, we all have our own seasons. So right at this moment, I will also put mine. Spring, because I'm going to my mom's place. All the women out here must be, married women especially. They know how I'm feeling. Okay. Okay, so we got a brief idea about how we are feeling, if we can relate ourselves to different seasons. Now what we do is engage in an art activity where we are kind of drawing. Okay, and coloring. This will be a art and coloring activity. You divide the page into four halves. If you have four seasons, so you can have one more in the middle also. That's okay. Divide the page and try to draw the seasons. Okay, and how you feel about each season. Then we'll reflect on that. Okay. So I'll give you approximately, say, 5 to 10 minutes to work on it. I'm also doing mine. Okay, so whenever you are drawing each season, try to understand how you feel or when you feel these elements, like summer. It's very hot and bright and sunny. So for some people, it may be overwhelming, discomfort. For some people, it may be a lot of activity. a lot of energy. Okay, so it may have personal meanings. This particular thing is for older children, okay, maybe 9 years onwards. But there will be certain modifications which I'll tell you, which you can do even with younger ones. Okay, this only you can modify through different elements.
Ma'am, I have a doubt. Can I ask?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, I just got disconnected, so I don't know what we're talking about. So what is the activity that we have to do?
We need a paper. Okay, we need a paper. We are going to divide it into 4 halves. Okay. And for each of these halves, what we are going to do is draw 4 seasons.
Okay. Got it. Thank you.
Okay, before I forget, for tomorrow's class, you'll be needing 4 A4 sheets. Markers or sketch pens, scissors and glue. Okay, so we'll do that activity tomorrow.
We have to draw what it comes to mind for the season, or what do we feel about the season?
Yes.
We have to write about that or draw?
First draw and then we'll discuss, and then you can write down with more time. Okay, so this drawing activity, whenever you are engaging a child into some drawing and concrete, you know, kind of craft making or something like that, this action initiates some kind of relationship with the entire activity. So always involve the children in doing the things through tactile sensations. So when they are drawing and understanding, it becomes much more concrete for them, rather than just discussing with them. There's no time limit to it, but again, keep a note of the time, how much time the child is taking. You may not hurry up the child into doing things.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
We have to draw all the 4 seasons or what?
Yes. It's preferred that you draw the 4 seasons.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
If the child is not good at drawing or the child is not interested in drawing, can we ask them to write the points or the season, what they enjoy or what they like the most?
In case the child is not interested in drawing, it's not that they are not good in drawing. It's more about if they are not interested. Yeah. What you can do is give them maybe Play-Doh.
Okay.
Even if the child doesn't want to, engage in that, they can make symbols for each season.
Okay.
Why we are doing this activity is to fixate the children into what they're doing. It becomes much more concrete and obvious. Something which is, tangible, where they can relate to.
Okay.
Or alternatively, what you can do is you keep a few season cards ready, like summer, winter. Very simple clip art drawings.
Okay.
you can keep them ready, or you can have blank templates where they can just fill in with color if they're not very confident about themselves or they don't want to engage in that.
Okay.
You can motivate them. Okay. Otherwise, okay, you can just show them the cards and tell them how do you relate or which season do you like the most if they are younger ones.
Okay.
And how are you feeling? If I have to tell you that spring is all about, you know, how do you feel about spring? Let them tell you. Let them describe. They can write down also. And then you relate that how are you feeling right now? Okay. We'll come to the writing part after we are done with the drawing. This approximately takes around 15 to 20 minutes to complete your all four squares. And many of us feel that children have to be very good in drawing in case they want to engage in art therapy sessions, but that's not the fact. It is only about the process. So if children or even adults come and tell you that, no, I'm not good in drawing, you say, that's just relax. It's not about how good you are. It's about the process, how you feel when you are engaging yourself in the activity. So encourage them in any possible way and tell them that. In case you want to share your work, whatever you have drawn in the class, you can share it in the group after we are done with the writing part also, or before that, whichever is you're comfortable with.
We have to write as well.
I'll tell you the writing part. We have not gone there yet. This is a very famous technique. It's called the Four Seasons technique, where you explore how you're feeling and how you can associate each of these seasons with your mood. An alternative to this would be picture cards, as I've told you. Younger children, they can relate to this more. It becomes easier for them to relate.
This feeling pie also very effective. Feeling pie activity.
Yes. There are lots, tons and tons of activities for understanding emotions.
So from where we can get this activity list or any idea?
There are books.
It's all.
There are online resources. There are books.
Okay.
Keep on updating yourself. It would be good if you can read books, because you know other internet resources, they just give you half the thing.
Yeah,
it's just a half information they'll give you. It wiser to read books.
Ma'am, can you suggest any good books?
Yes, I will send you.
Hello.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. Ma'am, there are one book for the school counselor. It's very good, and there are one book for school counseling. It's very good, and lots of case study also given in this book. And theory is also very simply they are given.
Yes. Which one, ma'am? Name
is, a school counselor book. Vikram Patel, Lisa, Gaurivan.
If you put it in the chat, maybe people can refer to that.
It's a very good book, because I had already read this book.
Okay, thank you for sharing.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I want to ask if it is like a raining season. So mostly raining season is in summer. So.
Okay.
If it's possible, can in the summer can be rain? It's okay.
Yes, it's okay. Absolutely fine.
All
Whichever
right.
Whichever way you perceive it.
Please, ma'am, the one who's telling about the book. Please, can you write the name of the book and also the author? Thank you.
So I'm done with mine. I just take a picture. I think that's So I've just sent mine. You can send yours before I wrote anything about it in the group. And I'll show you as well. People who are not there in the group, I can show you. So this is what spring looks like to me, winter, and then it's rainy, and then it's summer. Summer, if you see, I've just drawn the sun. For me, summer is all about discomfort and a lot of hot things. So even monsoon, I don't like monsoons, nor winter. I'm a very, what do I say? I love to be around flowers and hills.
Actually, sometimes it depends on place, ma'am, also, because Kolkata is really hot and humid, right?
Absolutely.
And in Bangalore, we have like always, we all are in monsoon only. So we all like, I think who all are in Bangalore, they like more rainy season and monsoon.
Absolutely.
Whenever I am in Kolkata, really I am feeling suffocated in monsoon there. So that is really tough.
Yes. Okay. You can still engage in this coloring and drawing activity. It's kind of, how are you feeling right now? How are you feeling? If I have to ask you, if you can put down a few words in the chat box when you're relating to each of these seasons and trying to contemplate or trying to understand how you feel about each season. While engaging in the activity, how are you feeling? Okay. for most of us, it would be more like loosening up, you know, when we start connecting with each other, the drawings, what we have done, childhood memories, yes.
It looks like what are we are expecting towards the season.
Mm-hmm. Right. A lot of emotions which come up while you are doing this activity.
So like spring season, I usually visit my mom's place. So we'll go out and enjoy. That kind of memories reflects that season.
Absolutely. You will see each child has a different memory set, you know, with each of these seasons. Some will enjoy monsoon, some will assign a lot of happiness with winter, some will assign a lot of activity happiness in summer. Okay, so it will differ from child to child. Even with adults, if you're doing this, we'll see each of them has a different personal story attached to all these four seasons. Okay, so it's all about letting go, being in the moment, and then working on this reminiscence, a lot of reminiscence. So what next we have to do is, we try to write down the emotions which we are feeling with each of these seasons. Say, for instance, for me, spring would be the most feeling the most comfortable or feeling very happy. For summer, it would be, I would write some kind of discomfort or anger or frustration, if I have to write that. For winter, it would be more about loneliness and depression. For monsoon also, it's more about being extremely lack of energy, feeling lack of energy. So we write down our emotions attached to each of these. For children, you can improvise, you can have simpler emotions. Like how would you, which season would you assign for happiness? They just put a tag or they write it down. Which season would you assign for sadness? This one. Which season would you attach for a lot of energy and activity? Whichever they want to, they assign. Simple terms, simple emotions. And then you move on, maybe throughout your counseling sessions, you can have this theme of seasons. You can have it maybe on a poster or maybe on the... on the black this thing, the soft board, and then they, whenever they come to your session, they can talk about, okay, I'm feeling spring today. So that's the way, you know, children connect. Okay, so the moment they come in, it's not about how what they're feeling they have to express. It's only that they put a maybe a pin on that, or maybe they point out that this is how I'm feeling. Okay, especially children who are very not very expressive, shy. Okay, it will be a great way of connecting with their emotions. So even when you are doing, you will see that, yes, if you start assigning yourself every day that I'm feeling spring today, or tomorrow maybe I'm feeling monsoon tomorrow. So it's like you exactly know what's going on inside you, and it's a fun way of engaging with children. So you can quickly write down in each of these seasons what all emotions you are assigning to it. And then we'll move on to the variations. Would anyone like to talk about certain things here? Any reflection? Any reflection?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, is there any seasonal depression?
Pardon me?
Seasonal depression.
Seasonal, yes. It's called affective disorder. Seasonal affective disorder. It's called SAD. SAD. Okay, it's more about people who are living, especially in areas where there is a lack of sunshine. Yes.
That's in February mostly, I think. Month of February.
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
There is a scientific reason behind it. It's due to lack of sunlight. You don't get enough sunlight, that's why.
Yes, ma'am.
The moment they are exposed to sunlight or bright lights, studies have shown that their mood also improves a lot. So it's more physiological.
Okay, prolonged. That is why sunlight is suggested for depressive people.
Yes, yes. A lot of sunshine is required for you.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome. So many people are writing a lot of things, but no one seems to talk today. So
I have seen this mental health setting when I was working. During this winter season, you will get a lot of relapses.
Yes, absolutely.
The depression.
Yes. See, again, it depends on the geographical area you are in. Okay, if you have a pretty bright winters, especially in Calcutta, we generally have bright winters. So it's not that you may face certain depressive symptoms during that period of time. But places or locations throughout the world, most of the time, winters are very drab and gray and lack of sunlight. So there people might be facing a lot of trouble with their moods. Okay, so y'all are writing spring for a few people. It's energetic, happy, love. Winter is for sleeping, coffee time, family gathering time. So fine. So what is the agenda behind doing this or engaging in this activity? It is simply to make you feel good, especially. Yes, ma'am, please go ahead.
No, I didn't say anything.
Okay, so especially to engage in this activity and to feel good of what you are doing, and then how you can come and simply point out, you know, small children, they'll come and point out, okay, how do you think you are feeling today? Can you take up a card and talk about it? Maybe you can just, you know, cut these cards for the children. You can cut these and paste it behind a cardboard and keep it ready. Whenever they come, you place it. Whenever you see the child is upset, the child needs certain kind of, you know, pep talk or maybe not feeling right. So you can just extend the cards to them and tell them that which card would you pick today? So how are you feeling? This would be a starting point for other discussions as well. Okay.
Ma'am, could you repeat it, please? I got cut off.
I said whenever children are coming, young children are coming, what you can do is when after they are done with these four squares, you can cut them up. Make it separated and maybe paste it behind on a cardboard so that it becomes stiff. You can reuse it. Whenever they're coming to a session, they can, you know, if you feel that, yes, some talking needs to be done, they need to vent out, you can start off with this. Their cards, you can start off, you can place it in front of them and maybe suggest that, how are you feeling today? Can you pick up a card and start talking? Is it okay? So that's the way they will start talking about certain things, are maybe bothering them. A few improvisations which you can make. Next slide, Roshmija. You can have the weather, okay? This can be modified into the weather, sunny weather, rainy weather, thunderstorm, okay, or a light breeze. All these are metaphors. This is a part of metaphor therapy where you are attaching certain meanings to certain intangible objects around us, intangible things around us. So a thunderstorm may represent that something is really wrong with me. I need to cool off. Okay, so something has really disturbed me and I'm very, very angry. So it can be a thunderstorm, it can be foggy, that means I can't think clearly, I'm not able to concentrate today. So it's all about being foggy. Then you can have, I'm feeling rainy, it's raining. So it's more like a lot of clouds, a lot of worry, a lot of crying which was done. Okay, so that can have another meaning to it. Or maybe sunshine. Sunshine would be represented as feeling really happy and positive and all, energetic. So this can be replaced by weather. This can be also replaced by any of the elements, you know, water in another case. It can be a huge waterfall or a Niagara fall, which is enormous and gigantic and very powerful, which can denote that I'm really, really disturbed. Something big has happened. Or it can be a very silent stream, which is gently flowing. That means I'm in a happy mood, I'm in a good mood. Or maybe a very still lake. That means nothing is happening, I'm very demotivated. Okay, or a muddy puddle of water. Something to do with a lot of disgust or self-loathing, and I'm not feeling right. So all these can be replaced, you know, these metaphors can be replaced. Instead of seasons, you can always have these cards as well in front of you. younger children, it would be better if you already have ready-made templates cut out and kept with you, so that you can just show and tell them maybe a story, weave around a story, and then they relate to the emotions. This is a part of psychoeducation for them. There are several other methods also which you can teach them in order to psychoeducate them about emotions. There can be another strategy, can be there can be few blank templates, the faces of children blank, nothing drawn on it, and then you assign a few emotions, basic emotions, and ask them to draw it out. You know, the moment they draw, you will get to know whether they are on the right track or not. Maybe happiness, if the child just draws a straight line, you teach them how to draw a curvy line, and then once they see others smiling, that means the child, other child is happy. Especially children who have a lot of miscommunication errors, perception errors, autistic children, Asperger syndrome, they will have certain issues with understanding the expression of other children or what the motive behind their acts or behaviors. So psychoeducating about emotions becomes extremely crucial at that point of time. So these are a few strategies which are creative, which will involve a lot of fun, a lot of colors, which can relax the children. You know, they are drawn towards colors. So you can have an option of colors in front of you, if you can arrange it. And then they start engaging in talking, feeling happy in the end. Okay. Along with the psychoeducation part, they also tend to relax through these activities. And this is a great activity to do in groups. When you're physically doing it with children, it becomes way more fun. Okay, each child will talk about the seasons, each child will talk about the weather, or if it's water, anything which you are you know, passing around, it will be a lot of fun seeing other children what they are coming up with. So a great activity for classrooms also. Okay, I think we are done with it. Any questions I can take?
Ma'am, I want to ask if it is like a, when we give these activities to the children, so they will not speak about their feelings, emotions, but they are going to speak about the season, you know. So like this season I like, this season is like, so it's how we can clearly understand that in their inside what are the what season is going on. So how we
that's what we did, you know, labeling of the seasons. Once we are done with the drawing part, then you ask them, how do you feel about this season? What do you think spring is? Is it joy? Is it happiness? Or is it something else? Basic emotions. And then you move on to winter maybe. Ask the child, strike a conversation with the child and tell them then, how do you feel about winter? Then they talk about their emotions about winter. You know, looking at this picture or looking at winter or understanding winter, I feel very cold. I tend to, you know, go inside my bed sheets. So you tell them that, okay, is it that you feel a little bit lazy during winter? So you don't like much of movement? So maybe you can put this word down, you know, feeling lazy. Simple words for the children. For adults, you can have in lots of variations. Okay, that's not a problem. For maybe summer season, they can say that, okay, looking at the sun, I feel hot, I feel discomfort, I don't like it, you know, I don't like summer season. So you say, maybe you can then write down that summer may be a very hot time for you. How do you feel when you're hot? You're angry. Maybe summer can tell you that you're angry. So this is a personal coding system. It's not nothing that everyone has to write the same thing. But this is very, very personal coding system. So it's just through seasons. Why we are engaging in this? Because children relate to these drawings, relate to certain other objects rather than using heavy terms.
You know, you can also ask, what do you do when you feel happy, or what makes you happy? So you can connect to those questions also.
Yes, absolutely. They can connect whatever
they will answer usually.
Yes. So when they have pictures, they connect more rather than just simply words put across. If you ask them, are you upset? Maybe first time they'll say, no, I'm not upset. But if you talk about monsoon season, okay, I see monsoon is about, you know, cloudy days and very dark clouds, worries, and a lot of water around, which you don't like, which you have written. So are you feeling monsoon today? if you change the verbatim, if you change the words, they simply connect with you. You know, immediately they'll connect. Yes, I'm feeling monsoon. You know, just changing the thing.
You can also check zones of regulation activity.
Yes, yes.
Children, they can easily understand because yes. It was in the colors.
Mm-hmm. A lot of color usage with children is very, very good, in fact. They love using colors. The more you engage them in coloring, drawing, they love it. They love these activities. Maybe not all children. For children who are not engaged in drawing, you can do something else. Maybe with Play-Doh or with sand or something else. But engaging children in activities and then psychoeducating through these activities is a very good option. Because you'll have perfect tools to move ahead.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
मैम छोटे बच्चों की मन की बातें कैसे निकालें. फॉर एग्जांपल यहाँ आर्ट एक बहुत बड़ा काम करता है. हम यहाँ पे कोई भी ड्रॉ पर्सन टेस्ट या फिर कोई जो अभी आपने बताया सीजन के लिए वो भी कर सकते हैं. बट इसके अलावा और कुछ है आर्ट के अलावा और कोई टेक्निक्स जो
इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स स्पेशली द रेन स्टिक यू नो रेन स्टिक देन ड्रम्स सिंपल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स इवन इफ यू हैव फ्यू कप्स एंड बोल्स एंड अ फ्यू स्पून्स दे कैन जस्ट स्टार्ट engaging in that. And similarly, like we draw, they can also engage in this particular music and talk about how the music, how they feel about that music. Like drums, if example I'm giving you, if they're beating the drums very hard and then you say it's how do you feel about that loud noise, or how do you feel about this noise, and then you go on to a much more musical thing, you know, maybe a kind of a water bowl with a stick, softer tones. How do you feel these are, and how, whom would you say you are? You know, personifications, a lot of metaphorical personifications. So instantly the child says, I'm maybe the bowl, the small bowl, but actually the child may have been very aggressive, beating the drum very vigorously. So you instantly understand, okay, I see, how can you behave like the small bowl of water? You know, let's see how you do it. And then they start mimicking a lot of role plays. Incorporated. So it's not only one technique, you can fuse it, you know, you can have a fusion of it.
Okay. Thank you.
Once you start implementing, see, these may be new for many of y'all. So once you start implementing, you will see the difference yourself, how they start engaging and how easily they express.
मैम वन ऑफ द बेस्ट टेक्निक आई स्टार्ट फ्रॉम ये मैंने नोटिस किया बच्चे बहुत जल्दी रिवील करते हैं कि उनको कौन सा कार्टून पसंद है.
यस सुपर हीरोज कार्टून्स देयर इज अ सेपरेट सेक्शन अबाउट सुपर हीरोज
एग्जैक्टली
या
यस मैम
एन एंटायर स्टडी ऑन सुपर हीरोज एंड हाउ दे एंगेज स्पेशली टीन्स.
यस मैम
कार्टून्स यस अ वेरी बिग एरिया वेयर यू कैन एक्सप्लोर.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Ma'am, I have a question.
Yes.
So once if they have drawn all the four seasons and they come next to you in any other session and then you ask, like, how are you feeling? And somehow they are feeling something connected to different things. For example, if they are feeling both the things, like winter and summer, then I will pick up the things because it might be very different from each other and at the same time they might be contradictory.
Mm-hmm.
So how do you pick up?
Okay, so you can pick up a line from there and you can ask, okay, I understand that you're feeling both summer as well as winter, maybe both contradictions if I have to assume. Then you say, okay, what made you feel summer and what made you change into winter, or vice versa. You know, you need to incorporate certain things which children understand. Whenever we are trying to displace their feelings into something inanimate or something, some objects, okay, that's the time they start talking about things because they feel less threatened. Okay, they relate to that object being very angry. Like we know, younger children, if they get hurt, they will hit the bed rather than thinking that it's my fault that I've been careless. Okay, so children have that tendency still when they are growing up, still they have the tendency to put the blame on others rather than actually, you know,
taking the responsibility on themselves.
Right. Ma'am, what is that?
You said, also.
animals.
How many people were talking about putting the blame on others, no?
Yes.
This could be because of the parents, you know, whenever the child falls, or the wall you fell because of the
it hit
the bed. You know, it's even the parenting that comes up in
that matter. Yes. That's a very natural phenomena and it's present in children.
Yeah, and we see it so often, like, you know, if you fall, the book fell on you, this is bad book, you know. That's how the parents actually, but they don't realize what they're doing.
Right. Children feel more safe and secure if the blame goes on to something, some other object. In this case, it may be the art, it may be the musical instrument, it may be something else.
Yeah, that's really
okay. They try to process the information in a better way then.
Ma'am, we can use animals' name also, lion, deer.
Yes, of course. You can always use animals. Anything, as I told you, it can be any improvisions. You can have a number of improvisions there.
Ma'am, once they identify like a superhero or an animal, how do you deal with it? So is it more like they have similar characters, that's why they're relating to that?
Yes. Relationships with the particular, how they perceive the superhero, or how they perceive this particular animal, what are the characteristics of each of these being stated by the child. So you have to go only by the characteristics. If a child tells you a tiger is adorable, that means it is adorable. I'm not going to change the verbatim or the feeling of the child. Okay, if the child picks up a monkey and says this is an elephant, I have to go with that. I'm not going to challenge the child on anything. And that's the rule of play therapy, you know.
No argument with the child.
You have to go and we keep on exploring, asking them questions. So it becomes much more of their responsibility to understand. It's not that what I'm telling you, you have to do. It's about finding out.
Excuse me, ma'am, can I add something?
Yes, please.
As superheroes ka topic abhi hua hai to jaise I'm working with a girl, she is 5 to 6 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And once I asked her that why Hage Maru cries a lot, Shinchan's शिनचैन की छोटी बहन क्यों रो रही है वो बहुत परेशान करती है बट रिप्लाई में शी सेड अभी वो छोटी है ना इसीलिए और वो बच्ची भी छोटी है जिसके साथ मैं वर्क कर रही हूँ तो हो सकता है वो मन से यही कह रही है कि मैं भी अभी छोटी हूँ इसलिए भी मेरी भी कुछ चीजें इग्नोर कर दो बड़े होकर मैं भी समझ जाऊंगी
यस
दिस इज हाउ चाइल्ड रिलेट्स
यस इट्स ऑब्जेक्ट रिलेशनशिप्स व्हाट दे फॉर्म
Yes.
They are forming certain relationship with certain objects or people or cartoons, whatever they are seeing. And then how they start relating, they'll tell you the story, how the other child in the cartoon is feeling.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, if the child gives excuse, agar bachche ki koi galti nikalti hai aur bachcha, hum bachche ko blame nahi kar rahe hain. हम ब्लेम भी नहीं कर रहे डांट भी नहीं रहे बट स्टिल ही कीप्स ऑन गिविंग एक्सक्यूजेस ये इसलिए हो गया तो उस टर्म्स में बच्चे को कैसे हम समझाएं
कि द लास्ट यू नो व्हेन दे स्टार्ट टेकिंग ब्लेम ऑन देमसेल्व्स एंड देन दे स्टार्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट नहीं मैंने नहीं किया इट्स एन इंडिकेशन दैट समवेयर द पेरेंट्स आर बीइंग हाइपर विजिलेंट अबाउट एवरीथिंग यू नो एवरी ड्रॉप ऑफ द हैंड मे बी सर्टेन इश्यूज आर कमिंग अप और दे आर पोकिंग द चाइल्ड नहीं मत करो ये छोटी बच्ची है सिस्टर को मत सताओ या यू आर द ओल्डर वन यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड हाइपर विजिलेंस मे बी इज गोइंग ऑन इन द हाउस सो दैट्स व्हाई द चाइल्ड इज ऑलवेज हैविंग दैट यू नो बैरियर इन फ्रंट ऑफ देम दैट बिफोर समवन टेलिंग मी आई विल टेल द पर्सन व्हाट माय एक्सप्लेनेशन इज
प्रॉब्लम इज वन वे ऑफ एक्सप्रेसिंग द चाइल्ड्स नीड्स एक्चुअली
Exactly, I have noticed कि उनके parents over बहुत ज़्यादा बोलते हैं कि ऐसे नहीं करना वैसे नहीं करना बहुत ही formal रहना even in fact घर में भी बहुत formal रहना है तो शायद ये reason हो सकता है
lots of rules and hyper vigilance as I said
exactly
that's an indication so you can work on the parenting but वो भी बहुत बड़ा एक challenge है
बहुत बड़ा
But now I see parents changing, you know, it's a good thing. A few will be there, of course, but most of them actually listen to you. And it does bring about a lot of changes, positive changes in the child, once they start implementing what you tell them.
But ma'am, the boy I'm talking about, unki mom teacher hai. Kafi high school mein hai, toh mujhe lagta hai thoda problem hoga mujhe parent ko guide karne mein. Let's see.
Ek aasan tarika hai, you know, you can... this is the strategy which I use. I shouldn't be saying this, but anyway, this is kind of leveraging them. You know, you are so smart. I'm pretty sure putting the responsibility in a very positive way. Even if they are not doing, I'm pretty sure you're doing your best. You're the best parent I've come across. Even white lies will do. The moment they feel important, they'll take the responsibility.
Okay, ma'am, sometimes I do screenshot some quotations and then I put them on WhatsApp on yes. parenting. But yes. yes. scene kar rahe the, I get to know that they've read it.
They're reading, yeah. That's a good
strategy. You can share some good resources also with them about parenting. If they are okay. educated and they will understand.
We generally have a handbook every, you know, for parents who are coming. We hand them over, but hardly people read. I don't think they read it.
मैम बहुत मुश्किल होता है पेरेंट्स को समझाना शायद बच्चे आसानी से समझा सकते हैं हम लोग लेकिन पेरेंट्स को समझाना बहुत मुश्किल होता है
एंड एट द सेम टाइम मैम पेरेंट्स को समझना भी बहुत मुश्किल है क्योंकि वो हमारी जगह नहीं है और हम उनकी जगह नहीं है
बहुत बहुत यस या एक्चुअली इट इज इजियर सेड देन डन बिकॉज पेरेंट्स हु आर हु हैव चिल्ड्रन विद लर्निंग डिसेबिलिटी और एनी काइंड ऑफ डिसेबिलिटी नो इट्स अ बिग चैलेंज टू कीप ऑन टेलिंग देम pointing out all the time so make the yes. session much more constructive you know highlight the strong points in the child they'll feel good that yes I'm coming to a session I'm getting positive feedback about my child problem solve yeah. rather than point out faults in the child. We don't do it of course we don't do it but parents have this barrier whenever they're coming to the session they are prepared that nahi kuch na kuch galat sunne ko milega avoid that part we know all the faults in the children so why to highlight it again and again more focus on what the developments are and even yes. if it's a very slight change in the child highlight that and then problems yes. are that this can be the course of action so we're trying to you know focus on this now
in fact ma'am I try to understand those parents kyunki unke jo bade bete hain he is also diagnosed with dyslexia तो छोटे oh. बेटे के लिए वो कंसर्न ऑटोमेटिकली आना ही है इसलिए मैं उनको पॉइंट भी नहीं कर सकती कि इतना ओवर कंसर्न क्यों है सो दैट इज व्हाई जब तक उनके शूज में हम फिट नहीं होंगे ना तो हम ये सोच भी नहीं सकते कि वो जरूर चल रहा होगा उनके दिमाग में
करेक्ट सो लॉट ऑफ एम्पैथेटिक लिसनिंग ऑल द स्किल्स ऑफ अ काउंसलर डबल्स इट
यस मैम
एज वेल एज द पेरेंट्स You know, all the skills of the counselor it is doubled while we are dealing with children and especially patient listening
yes ma'am
rather than passing our own you know in certain times you do need to guide children when they are a little lost or when they don't have any direction but most of the time non-directive way becomes a very good way of dealing with children and understanding them and guiding them you know they themselves yes, explore
and then yes ma'am What language should we give to the child in case of explanations? क्या कहना चाहिए उस टाइम बच्चे को मुझे उस टाइम समझ नहीं आता
explanation see it's a vast area to deal with you know you need regular training and then sessions and then a lot of in-depth knowledge about how to deal with children but non-directive hoga it would be more like what do you feel like doing you suggest me if they are not coming up with certain ideas you can give them options this Now you tell me if you want to engage in this thing. You know, whatever they are doing, I can see you are sitting quietly. Is there anything I can help you with? You know, a helpful factor rather than telling you, why don't you do this? Okay, just proceeding or taking the sessions, holding the hands of the child, and then going along the way where she or he wants to lead you.
Yes, ma'am.
So... it takes a little time for them to open up it takes maybe a little more time than required but whenever they are improving it will be a more long term effect
okay thank you so much
they start connecting with themselves okay so today this was it I'll be meeting you tomorrow please keep your supplies ready so that we can engage in this would be a kind of a booklet making which I'll teach you it's a very simple activity but again it's very powerful for children they can keep it with themselves okay bye bye see you tomorrow
bye bye ma'am thank you ma'am
okay I'm putting my number one second
thank you ma'am
thank you
The group is only for winners. Okay, if you're one and you're not included, just text me personally.
Okay.
When is the last day, ma'am?
Friday would be your last day, and then we'll have two more sessions in the next week. I will tell you the day for the next week. Because Monday I'll be a little engaged, maybe Tuesday, and then a practice session right after that.
Okay. And we'll be receiving a physical certificate or an...
No, we'll send you via mail.
Ma'am, the practice session will only be for the ones who have won, right?
Yes, yes. Only the winners.
This Saturday we have session,
ma'am? No, not Saturday, ma'am. Saturday, okay. Sunday we don't have sessions.
Okay.
Ma'am, I
will tell you on Friday next week. Either it's Tuesday, Wednesday or Wednesday, Thursday. I will confirm on Friday, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
रिया मैम,
यस मैम,
मैम आपने जैसे एक एग्जांपल दिया था कि अगर इफ यू आर फाइंडिंग कि चाइल्ड इज अपसेट देन मॉनसून लाइक मॉनसून इज अ वरी और लाइक फीलिंग दैट वे वी वर रिलेटिंग बट इफ द चाइल्ड रिलेट्स मॉनसून विद हैप्पीनेस
राइट
सो दैट वुड
Yes, of course. It is child specific, ma'am, as I have told you. For different children, different seasons will mean different emotions. So you only have to go by whatever the child says. It's not how we perceive the seasons as. Okay, whatever the child says, you can, cut these and paste it on a cardboard. Let them do it and keep it with you or keep it with them. Whenever they are coming to your session, they can bring it. If you feel that something is off, you can start off with this. Let's make it a ritual also. Sometimes we do make it a ritual that whenever you're coming, you have to show me the card which you're feeling. So that's kind of when they enter, they show you the card. Okay, I'm feeling sad, happy, whatever the feelings are. And if you feel that there are negative emotions, then you start exploring.
So this means you have to first... know the perceptions of that child regarding
yes things. Yes, when you're engaging in this activity, explore. Okay, when yeah. you're engaging in this activity, you have
so to ma'am, ma'am, should we ask them the reason behind their disliking for some particular season?
You may or may not, depends on the child's maturity. Okay, because many a times if they are not very expressive, they might find it difficult to tell you why they feel like. Okay, if you want to explore further, you may. No problem in that.
Okay.
This you can do it with older children when they have concrete systems, when they can analyze certain things.
Sure.
Okay. Bye bye. Take care.
Ma'am, bye.
Take care, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Ma'am, I have messages to you, ma'am.
Okay, I'm looking.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Bye.
Bye.